let's go. This is it.
Those monsters, they're gonna get me. No, you won't leave me like all the other grown-ups. You can help me. You will? My house is the one. Please. You know, maybe this will help, and maybe it won't. But Pop, he... Well, there is the person. Papa always said to stay away from... Cool. Can I try?
I know, kid. Just get one. You've been pissing me off. Get shit.
Personality, Robco, R04B9.
Oh, shit. That was... Oh my... See, this is all I have to do. Really? Really? Really?
Smell. I was just testing a few chemicals, but it's perfectly safe to breathe. Really? So, how's the scavenging been? Got the food and medicine from that super duper mart? Really? You did? You did! Well, all right! Tell me all about it. So you're saying that they acquired a well-protected stash? I wonder how many other places are hiding treasures behind monsters. Well, keep what you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit, my treat. Tastes kind of great after a while. Oh, and take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink more, better. I still need to study a living specimen with radiation poisoning. I need someone to research how to travel through a minefield. And that'll cover the first section of the book. Which strikes your fancy? Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it? I know lots about it from books, but I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning, so I can study its effects. Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that. Oh, but nothing beats a... Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost town that's just full of mines. Traders just call the place Minefield. Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get back, and tell me all about it. And could you bring back a mine for my studies? I hear there's a... Oh, you're a peach. Now, 200 rads should be enough for basic sickness. But if you can get 600 or more rads, my test will be even more accurate. Just make sure you can get back here, and I'll see to it that you're well taken care of. Take care. It's a big wasteland, but you know that better than me, right?
Reminder of the division that has occurred in the past. And the resplendence of the promise of our division in the times to come. Give your bodies to Adam, my friend. Release yourself to his power. Feel his glow and be divided. There shall be no tears, no sorrows, no suffering. For in the division, we shall see our release from the pain and hardships of this world. Yea. Your suffering shall exist no longer. It shall be washed away in Adam's glow, burned from you in the fire of his brilliance. Each of us shall give birth to a billion stars formed from the mass of our wretched and filthy bodies. Each of us shall... shall be mother and father to a trillion civilizations. Each of us shall know peace, shall know an end to pain, and shall know Atom in his glory. I urge you, my friends, come, drink with me and pray. Glorious Atom, I give unto you these feeble bones. I present to your will this frail body. I beg of you to use me as your vessel. Guide me to your brilliance. Divide each particle and give relief to this rotten flesh. Cast the fragile form of this ephemeral body into new life in the forge of your glow. Atom, come.
Oh, feeling a bit under the weather, or a bit over the Geiger counter? I can tell, you're positively glowing. Now, just hold on and try not to move. Tell me how it feels, and I'll get you fixed right up. You're a mighty lucky one, you know that? At this state, most people would have trouble standing up, much less walking over here. Now, let me take a few notes, and I'll handle that nasty radiation with a bit of my own homemade rad cure concoction. I've never had a chance to test it out on someone so heavily dosed, but I'm sure it'll work out fine. Exciting, isn't it? Okay, a little Brahmin milk, a couple magnets, and maybe a few happy thoughts. Well, you're alive! Oh, that's the good news. But there was a little side effect. A teeny tiny, mutation. But it seems to be benign, at least. Here, take a few radiation chems, as my little way of saying, I'm sorry I twisted your DNA like a kitten with a ball of yarn. Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost.
Now come on.
Are those hot little potatoes? Because, you know, they're on the ground, like potatoes, and hot because they, explode. Anyway, what's up? My very own landmine! Oh, just what I've always wanted. Well, always since I sent you out on this anyway. Now, tell me all about it. What was it like going through there? What's it like disarming a landmine? That's a pretty good way of putting it. I think I'll use that in the book. Maybe I should credit you as a co-author instead of just a researcher. I know you may not want to see any more explosives for a while, but obviously you know your way around them. Have a couple rainy day toys of mine. And looking at this landmine, it gives me an idea. It's a terrible device that does terrible things, of course, but it's easy to make your own, too. Yep, you've done a great job. I just need to add in the section on how to cook rat, and this chapter's done. Here, for your services, I've saved up quite a few stim packs. Of course, you may need them. We still've got 2 more chapters to go. The second chapter is going to be a bit trickier, I think. It'll cover how to handle creatures out there, for better or worse. For example, repelling mole rats, learning about mirelurks, and when all else fails, how to handle being injured. So let's buckle down and get to work on this chapter. What's first? Mole rats can burrow into almost anything and cause a lot of trouble. So I figured I'd make a chemical repellent stick for people to shoo them off. But I need it to be tested before I put the recipe to paper in the guide. So I need you to find some mole rats and test it out a bit.
Thank you.
range, this giant has a lot of range. Surprisingly, too. Let me kill these assholes.
Oh, I can't wait to hear how the repellent's working. Those poor little mole ratties. I wonder if I could make a hypoallergenic version. Oh, but that'd hardly be effective. I should mention that. Proper handling of mole rats could be important if they could be domesticated. Milked, maybe? Oh, anyway, keep the repellent. Oh, but for your trouble, here, have the leftover chems from working on the repellent. I'm sure you can find some use for them. There's a lot we don't know about Mirelurks and how intelligent and dangerous they are. That definitely deserves research. I hesitate to ask, but I'll need to examine the effects of serious physical trauma. I wouldn't ask if I couldn't fix you up afterwards, of course. And that should be it for the second chapter. Which do you want to check out? That's great. Are they intelligent? Do they have a leader? Some sort of king or priests or some sort of scaly community center? I'll bet most people would have just gone in there, guns blazing without half a thought. But not you. You're the best research assistant ever. I've been getting a good signal, but what do you think about them from your first-hand observations of them? Very scientific of you. Personally, I wasn't sure if they were crabs or if they came from some sort of brine shrimp, perhaps. Some of these observations about their armor and camouflage gave me an idea for reinforced, neutral-colored headgear. Here, consider it thanks for not interfering with them. Oh, speaking of which, take these, so you can continue to avoid them in the future. Great! I never get to study anyone who's severely injured. Not without them crying to be fixed right away or trying to bleed out and all that. But obviously, you can handle a lot of abuse. So if I'm ever going to find a good example of human anatomy and injury resistance, it'd be you. Next time you get badly injured, return here so I can examine you before I heal you up. I mean, you're going to get yourself hurt anyway, right? Wow, what a great research assistant you are. I mean, really, that's dedication. Demonstrating how to withstand pain by getting injured? Wow. When you're ready, come back here with some serious injuries. Maybe a crippled limb or two, and I'll take notes and fix you up. I'll be waiting here with plenty of bandages for you. So don't worry. Just go get horribly injured. Oh, and be careful. Well, how do you feel? Oh, I know it does, dear. But it's for a good cause. Try not to squirm so much while I take notes. Now, how would you describe the pain you're feeling? Any advice for how to keep it from being overwhelming? And remember, this is for posterity. That's a very enlightened attitude you've got. Shame it doesn't stop bullets, huh? Luckily, I'm here to patch you up. Now hold still and quit fidgeting. Ugh. How can you be walking around like this? Okay, I even stitched a little smiley face in you to keep up your spirits. It's kind of hard to see from your side, though. Here, take this environment suit of mine. It will help with medical tasks, and it should help prevent the effects of exposure, too. Correct as always. And your feedback's really led to a very smartly written book. Maybe too smart for some folks, I worry. Of course, if the reader can't be bothered to understand something important as a book on how to stay alive, then what can we do, huh? And in case those readers blame you for their ignorance, here's your payment. 2 big boxes of ammo. Now, on to the next chapter. The last chapter is a bit more esoteric. It's about the survival of humanity as a whole and how to rebuild society. Deep stuff, huh? We need to know how large settlements are formed, how to harness the old technology, and I'll need you to get ancient history from a nearby library. We're in the last stretch now, so let's finish it up strong. What's first? Don't be so sure. You'd be surprised how confused people get, even about important things. In this case, I'm talking about Rivet City. It's the most successful survivor settlement around, but no one here really knows how it started. Of course, that's why it's important to know how a place like that succeeded. So I need you to go there and do some researching. I'm Belle Bonnie. In this, I'll tell you what I tell all the fresh meat. Don't start anything. You must be drunk. Are you gonna order or what? History? What, not enough shit around here already? You need to dig up more? Don't know if it ever had an official start. It's just been here forever. Stuck in the river and full of assholes. No, I can't fucking well share one. What sort of moron are you? But fine. It'll get you out of my face. Go down to Pinkerton's shed in the broken-off bow of the ship. If he decides to give you a history lesson, it's no business of mine. Now get the hell out of my bar.
No, it's really stupid to have me go back out there again.
Hey there.
Stay sharp. They're everywhere. What? I have been. Ha. Sounds like you've been poking around, all right. I'm surprised any of those reprobates even remember me. Maybe they still laugh about how they edged me out of the council back then. But you can set the record straight. For that, you have to go all the way back to when remnants of the Naval Research Institute cleared the Mire Lurks off this wreck. About 40 years ago, we were looking for new lab space, and this bucket of bolts just happened to have a well-preserved science bay on it. Everything else just grew up around that lab once we got it up and running. The science team was led by one H. Pinkerton. That lasted until about 18 years ago, when those ambitious backbiters like Lee and her little team showed up. She came in with her big Purity Project pipe dream, and my whole staff started working with her, those traitors. She even took my seat on the council. By then, I was glad to leave it behind. But hell, if I'm leaving the city I made great. Of course I do. A good scientist always keeps track of their data. Here, They probably don't even remember, but I kept the records of that first council meeting. Take them, if it'll put them in their place.
Any luck finding out how Rivet City got started? Aha! Not just as easy as asking around, was it? Good information takes real work to uncover, after all. So, tell me all about it. With the protected location and resources that came from those scientific advances, I can definitely see how it grew so quickly. A bit of smarts leads to a big reward, huh? Speaking of which, in thanks, have a few of these. For the next time, you've got to be quick on your wits. Oh, and I'll let the Rivet City traders know they'll be favorably mentioned in the book. You'll get a discount buying gear from them in the future. I've got to do a section on working with old computer electronics. So there's some research to be done in the old Robco production facility. Also, there used to be a big library out there. Imagine a whole building full of books. I'll need you to gather information there for me. And that'll be it for the last chapter. So, what'll it be? It does, doesn't it? I mostly just deal with it after it's junked. But a trader gave me this Robco processor widget. He said it's worth a fortune. According to him, if it's connected to the mainframe in the Robco factory, you could have access to all the robots you'd ever want. Now that would be a great example of how to harness technology, wouldn't it? Yeah, you should just be able to plug it into the mainframe at the Robco production facility. It'll give you access to the robots and terminals. Okay, here. And be sure to keep an eye peeled for any other examples of how to make old technology work for you out there. Why, I'm flattered. What would you like to know? Well, look around at the world we live in. It may be okay to you, but I've read about what it used to be like. And this wasn't it. So we all need something that keeps us going, despite all the terrible things around us. For me, it's things like this book. No, it's like, did you ever try to put a broken piece of glass back together? Even if the pieces fit, you can't make it whole again the way it was. But if you're clever, you can still use the pieces to make other useful things. Maybe even something wonderful, like a mosaic. Well, the world broke, just like the glass. And everyone's trying to put it back together like it was. But it'll never come together the same way. Hey, it sounds crazy when you say it that way. But that's what I'm aiming for. Yeah. The Wasteland Survival Guide isn't much toward that lofty goal, but it's an important one. And that's why I need your help. I don't think I can do it alone. Keep up the great research, Super Assistant.
Damn you.
Engagement.
Cool. got. More weight to go.
Fiddled with any interesting technology lately?
Harnessing the technology of the past and modifying it for your own purposes? That's just the thing. Tell me all about how it worked out. Well, they're only human. Or, well, made by humans. Well, probably manufactured by other robots, but you know where I'm going with this. Seems like a good thing to watch for when dealing with tech of any age. And it helps to pack a few pulse grenades, just in case. Here, have a few. Oh, and take my book on science. For some reason, I just can't get into the computer parts, but I've got the rest pretty much memorized. Yes, books are where the old world kept its knowledge, and libraries are where it kept the books. And there's supposed to be one in Arlington. See if it's still there, and if you can download records from its computer, information dumps like those would be invaluable for rebuilding humanity. Great. The library should be in Old Arlington, not far from downtown. See if you can download the archives from its computer. If you can't get those, then even the card catalog would be useful. Any little piece of information could help the book, and thus humanity. Keep up the great research, Super Assistant.
Yay. Okay.
I am Senior Scribe Yearling, Order of the Word. I have a proposal for you, if you're interested. Good. My task here is to collect the written works of those who came before, in order to supplement the Brotherhood archives at the Citadel. Although most of the pre-war books have been destroyed, there are a few that have survived. But finding a book in these ruins is difficult. I could have a million initiates to comb the ruins, and I'd still never come close to recovering every book that remains undamaged. Precisely. The collected knowledge of a lost age is worth far more than any weapon. So, return here with any books that you find in good condition. I will compensate you for every volume that you bring me. Think on it, and return when you have books to offer me. You have...
what's that gonna do?
Where? Hostile is there. Commencing attack. The wasteland will play. Where? Really? What were you gonna do? What was you really gonna do? All right, let's get out of here. Again, I have to edit this when I get done with it. Because it'll get in the ass to deal with everything else.
Remember my offer. Welcome back. Excellent. How many are you willing to trade? Very well. Here is your reward. Use it well and return with more books when you can.
Yes.
to see you.
Damn, why I keep doing that?
Is it there? Are there books? Oh, can I go borrow some? Really? A whole library's worth of data? Right there? Oh, that's great news. So, what did you find? Tell me about it. I suspect you and I are two of the only people who really appreciate its value. Yes. Oh my goodness. When I'm done with this, I'll have to work on copying all of this information. It could take a while, you know. Oh, but here's a book of mine and some caps for your research. Think of it as pay for a civilization worth of overdue books. Yes, that concludes our exceptional expert endeavor. I have to admit, I was worried it would go over some people's heads, but it should be fine. For all your hard work, I want you to have this mini nuke. I kept meaning to use it to dig a well, but honestly, it just makes me nervous. Now, I just need to do a few last tweaks, and it'll be ready to print and distribute. Thanks for all the help. Oh my, it's brilliant. Even I'm astounded by my genius. Oh, no, it's more than that, by our genius. I'll share these with the traders, and soon everyone will know about the Wasteland Survival Guide. But now, the very first copy of our book goes to you. It wouldn't nearly be as good without your input. You're the real Wasteland Survival Guru. Come back soon.